The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made zakatul fitr compulsory on every slave, free man, male, female, young and old among the Muslims. One sa', which is a measurement of 4 double handfuls of dried dates, or one sa' of barley. Unfortunately, our community makes some basic boo-boos in the payment of zakatul fitr that needs to be clarified. Number one, paying at Eid Salah. Some people go to Eid prayers and drop money into the donation box thinking that they've paid zakatul fitr. No, zakatul fitr, which is food, must be in the hands of the needy family before Eid prayer. Number two, snail mailing the money overseas. One cannot mail the money overseas and have it arrive in the hands of the needy people after Eid prayer is over. It needs to be before. Number three, not paying. Yes, as simple as this boo-boo is, it is haram to skip the payment of zakatul fitr. Everyone has to pay zakatul fitr, every member of your household. So if you have 8 people in your house, zakatul fitr has to be paid times 8, even if the youngest member is just a few days old. Number four, confusing zakatul fitr with zakatul mal. We're talking about zakatul fitr here. Think iftar, i.e. Ramadan. Zakatul mal, and mal literally means wealth, is the zakat due on one's money. And that could be due any time during the year, depending on when it's due. Number five, giving money instead of food. Although some scholars have allowed giving money instead of food, the spirit of zakatul fitr is to give food to the needy of the community, not money. The companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiyallahu anhu, said, in the Prophet's time sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we used to give zakatul fitr as a sa' of food, dried dates, barley, raisins, or dried cheese. Number six, giving one zakatul fitr to a charitable building project. See, the spirit of zakatul fitr is that the needy should have plentiful food on Eid. All 8 types of recipients of zakat mentioned in the Quran are human beings, not building projects.